Hey everyone, Wazoo here, and this is my Let's Play of Shards of God. Yeah, if you recognize this game, we played a demo of it just a few short weeks ago during the Adventure Jam 2023 challenge, where contestants had 2 weeks to create an adventure game. I believe this was one of the entries, or the developer just happened to be working on it during the same time frame. I'm not sure. I'll have to look into it. But at any rate, the full version of this game is out now and available on itch. And so I thought I would give it another round. Let's try to finish the story from where we left off. I mean, we'll still play from the beginning, but I meant we'll be able to see more than what the demo had available to us. All right, let's get started. God Emperor Moon has ruled over the nation for millennia. None dare challenge the immortal's power. Only the Sisters of Vigil are privy to the Emperor's secrets. When the Divine Ruler calls, the Sisters answer. They listen, they observe, they ask questions, they solve problems. Great intro. And really cool artwork. So it's got very strong Dune-ish vibes, but it's definitely not set in the Dune universe, nothing like that, but just the look and style of it is very reminiscent, which is really cool. Really well done. Vigilant Mother Superior, Vigilant Sister Inferior? This is Sister Ava in training. And you must be Judge Maurus. Alas, the judge is currently indisposed. I'm Xavian, Imperial Scholar, Keeper of Knowledge, Archivist of Ancient. Our matter's urgent, Master Xavian. Certainly, when His Holiness calls, the sisters must come running. And may I inquire? You may not. Understood. Well, I'm here to assist you. If you wish to peruse the Imperial Library, it has been a pleasure. Out of the way, peasant. Don't worry, she's always like this. And now we get a small trip in the elevator. Going up the tower. Here we come. Ava. Yes, Mother Tiabata? You've been preparing for this moment, yes? Beyond this door lie Mun's chambers. Now before we enter, I'm prepared, Mother Tiabata. I've recited the prayers, revised the vows. Yes, yes, yes. Look, Ava, the Emperor. May his grace forever shine upon us. May not exactly be what you expect. Oh, do not worry, Mother Superior. I'm strong in the faith. Yes, that's the problem. Oh well, you'll process it one way or another. Process what, Mother Tiabata? I've always preferred showing over telling. Ooh, follow me, Ava. She gets mysterious. Mysterious Sister Ava. Mysterious Mother Superior. Your Highness? I bow before thee, O Mun, bringer of light. Hello? Anybody in there? Conqueror of... I said, is anybody in there? Mother Tiabata. Looks like I'll have to open it myself then. Open what? What a cool reveal. Oof. But what? What? Oh my. What? Who? We have a problem on our hands, Ava. Ava? I take your time. Many deep breaths later. So the God Emperor Mun, the holiest of holy, he whose light illuminates the darkest of souls. Is a suit? That's somewhat reductive. Mun is a dynasty, a dynasty which decided a long time ago to become a god by wearing a suit. Still reductive, but I'll grant it. The people in the suit might change with passing generations, but Mun lives on. He doesn't seem very alive now. Who knows about this? How does the suit work? Who is the dead man on the floor? Well, we'll leave that one to last. Who knows? Me, you, most of the other sisters of Vigil. And that's it? That's it. To everyone else, the God Emperor has been the same entity for millennia. Interesting. How does the suit work? And the suit? A marvel of technology. It maintains all life functions. Most emperors can barely walk by themselves. Everything is provided for them by the suit. And it is virtually impenetrable. Only the emperor and the sisters of Vigil can open it. Oh yes, you opened the suit. What sorcery was that? Not sorcery, technology. The amulet of Vigil we carry has many perks. No door stays closed to the vigilant sisters. Including the door of to into the God Emperor. Yes, but other than that, you could fire the nation's most advanced weapons at the suit, and it would barely leave a dent. Who was the dead man on the floor? Who is this? Was this man? Appearances would make it seem that we are looking at the latest incarnation of the God Emperor. So he summoned us before his death? Alas, no. The suit has a security system. If the Emperor's life is waning, a distress call is sent to the Vigilant Sisters. That's why we are here. We wouldn't want someone else to find him, who smites all evil in the state now, would we? Okay, who will be the new Emperor? That's a good question. If Mun is a dynasty, then where are the other Muns? Who becomes Emperor now? To my knowledge, the latest Mun had no direct descendants. But there are protocols in place for such cases. Secret heirs in secret locations. Once we report back to the Order, the Elder Mothers will know what to do. Let's do that then. Report to the Order. No. Not before we have some answers. The situation. Nothing like this has ever happened before. And I'm not letting anyone make a mess of things before I've had time to think. So for the time being, nobody, and I mean nobody, must know about what happened here. Yes, Mother Superior. So what do we do now? Well, this is a very unusual scenario. Very, very unusual. I need to think. Meanwhile, be a good vigilant sister and observe, will you? Examine the suit and the body too. Just let me think. Gulp. The body? So peculiar. The blood, the plates. Mother Tiabata? So peculiar. She's not listening. Use left mouse button to interact and right mouse button to examine. You can access items in inventory by moving the cursor to the top of the screen. Okay, so we have our amulet of Vigil. The amulet of Vigil. It can open any lock. It's also a communication device. Cool. Alright. Okay, so we have a decorative bowl. We have some fruit. We have a plate. It's a decorative plate with Mun's face on it. So you have seen what is there. Now do you also see what is not there? Huh? Never mind, you'll get there. Okay, fruit. Gnath fruit. They say it's very nutritious. Beautifully crafted bowl. This must be the creature known as Gnath. Can't wait to see one in the flesh. Okay. Got some pillows. They look very comfortable. Balcony. Perhaps the killer climbed in and out through the balcony. Highly doubtful. This is the tallest and best guarded tower in the whole nation. But yes, it is a possibility, I suppose. Okay, so we have an empty space here. This doesn't look right. There are three plates on the left, but only two on the right. Either a plate is missing, or Mun's Imperial Decorator has no sense of symmetry. Aha, finally the acolyte shows some observation skills. Mother Tiabata, you act as if this was the most important thing we have seen today. It may well be, Ava. It may well be. Okay, so we have another plate. So we have three plates on this side. Let's see another plant. Is this a Nath plant? I hear the way they grow those is very unique. Nothing to do with the dead emperor, though. Okay, let's... Oh, the vase? It's a beautiful vase. But as vigilant as I try to be, I see no relation to the emperor's murder. Okay, let's take a look at the suit. Let's see, we got a metal bar, we've got blood. Let's take a look at the blood. I don't want to touch it. Okay, there's blood on the inside of the lid. And we got a metal bar. What is this? A latch? It's a twin steel rod. But what does it do? Before the lid closes, the rod rotates to fit into the two holes on the suit's main part. It then literally wraps itself around the insides of the suit and welds itself to it. Only to be separated again when the Emperor and nobody but the Emperor chooses. So, it's a latch. Yes, Ava, it's a latch. Okay. That's a latch. Let's take a look at the body. So we got a wound. He has been stabbed in the chest with something. Perhaps a knife? He looks young for a god. Let's see, is there anything else? Anything else to click on here? Another vase. Not the best vase I've ever seen. I'd expect something fancier in the Emperor's chambers. Pots, flower pot, just some ugly empty pots. I don't see any connection with the task at hand. Okay, take it easy. Just checking out everything. Okay, that might be everything. Let's try and talk to Mother Tiabata again. Deep in thought as always. Okay. Curtains, no. Is there something else to look at? I'm not going to touch it. Just looking at it makes me queasy. I'm not touching the body. Okay. Okay. We looked at the suit. Looked at the body. Mother Tiabata? Have you finished, Ava? I've examined the room as you suggested, Mother Tiabata. And... The victim was stabbed while in the suit. He was stabbed in the chest with a sharp object. There's a plate missing from the wall. There is no murder weapon. Okay, so all these are true. Let's go through them one by one. There is blood on the inside of the suit's lid. It must have got there when the Emperor's chest was pierced. Which means that he was indeed killed while inside the suit. Good job. But even if the suit could be penetrated, that would surely leave a mark? Exactly. You see now why this is so interesting. Interesting is one way to put it. He was stabbed in the chest. I'm no medicine woman, but it seems Mun was stabbed in the chest with something sharp. A knife? Yes, it would appear so. I don't see what bearing this has on anything, but anything that may be of importance. Well, there's that decorative plate missing from the wall. Oh yes, the missing plate. But why would anyone kill a god to steal a plate? Strange, isn't it? That is what intrigues me. It doesn't fit. Perhaps the plate just broke at some point and never got replaced? Or his eternal light didn't care much about symmetry? Perhaps. Found nothing here that could have been used to kill this man. Not in the way he was killed, anyway. No murder weapon then, noted. Anyway, we indeed have a mystery on our hands, Acolyte. The mystery of the closed suit. So what do we do now? Simple. To unravel how such a crime could have been committed, we have to recreate it. Recreate it? Oh yes. That will be your task, Ava. Explore the city and find by what means the murder could have been committed. Then demonstrate it to me. Less than an hour ago, I thought Mun was a god. Then I learned it was a man. And that he is dead. Murdered. And now I have to find a way to kill him? Throw them in the deep end, that is what I always say. Where should I start and what will you do? Where should I start? Where should I start? I've never been to the Imperial City. Find that scholar man, Xavian. I believe he said he would be at the library. Scholar man. He should help you find your way around. Leaps over tall stacks of books with a single bound. Okay, and what will you do? Apologies, Mother Superior, but what will you do? You seem much better suited for this task. I will observe from a distance. And think, this situation is most peculiar, I know. She has some cheek. I will be on my way then. Yes, yes, off you go. And if I... The plate? Why the plate? Maybe, but no, that's not possible. And she's not listening again. Okay. Please note. The current version of the game has no autosave function. To save your progress, use the icon in the inventory bar and save manually. Old school. Okay, let's save it as soon as we get to a save point. So we were in Mun's chambers, and we have the library available to us. And that's it. Testing, testing. Uh-oh. 1, 2, 3. Mother Tiabata? Where are you? How are you speaking to me? Your amulet, acolyte. I said it has many perks. So it's a communication device. Not only that, it allows me to see what you see. Hear what you hear. Creep what you creep. Yes, practical. This way you can be my eyes and ears, Ava. I've noticed people tend to be a little tense when I address them. I wonder why that is. Anyway, I will contact you in due time. Proceed with your investigation. Greetings, Vigilant Sister. Pardon me for asking, but who are you just talking to? Ah, Master Xavian, was it? At your service. I was just talking to myself. I do that all the time. I'm not even lying. And now I said that out loud as well. Do not fret, Sister. I understand the burden of a restless mind. All the thoughts, they just want out, do they not? I suppose. Anyway, it's good I ran into you. Mother Superior said you can help me find my bearings. Certainly. Ask away. Let's see. Tell me about the Emperor's close circle. What places are there to visit? What do you think of the Emperor? That will be all for now. Tell me about the Emperor's close circle. As omnipotent as Emperor Esmon is, may his light forever illuminate our paths. He must have his people, no? Somebody who is, so to speak, second in command? Certainly, I pride myself to be one of those people. As the Imperial Scholar, my duty is to obtain and preserve knowledge. Then there is Radina. You will find her at the Nath Farms. Next is Maurus, the judge. As I relayed when we first met, he is currently indisposed. But he will surely be back, soon be back, to preside over any legal matters you may have. Catalyst is the head priest. You will find him in the temple. And finally, Rudilus, the general. As his title would suggest, he is in charge of military matters. What places are there to visit? Can you please help me find my way around the city? But of course, as you know, this is the Imperial Library. It stores many scrolls of ancient wisdom and also the Emperor's decrees. Then there are the Nath Farms. They are a natural marvel to behold. See, the Nath are large creatures who live in the desert. Only they're able to extract resources from the ground. And so the only place where we're able to grow anything is on their skin. Interesting. Then there's also the temple, a place devoted to honoring the great Mun. and finally the forge. We use the nation's most advanced technology to produce machinery and weaponry there. What do you think about the Emperor? What's your view of our supreme ruler, Master Xavian? Honored be the ground he walks upon. I admire the ancient wisdom an eternal being such as him must possess. It is true he's been showing some more expansive tendencies lately, but who am I to question the intentions of a god? He doesn't seem very happy with his god. Huh? Only you can hear me, Ava. Don't give it away. Understood. I'm glad you understand. Anything else? Emperor's decrees? You mentioned the Emperor's decrees. Yes, you will find them on the wall right here to your right hand. The Emperor's latest wishes and rulings are displayed there for all to see. Judge Maris. You mentioned the judge is indisposed. How exactly? Ha, straight to the point. A vigilant sister indeed. But to be frank, I am not sure myself. An important legal matter, perhaps? I'm sure he will tell you himself when you finally meet him. Okay. That will be all for now, Master Xavian. Thank you. May Mun shine his light upon you, vigilant sister. Okay, let's check out these scrolls. The archives of the Imperial Library are truly vast. Okay, I guess we'll look at the decrees. Okay, a decree of Mun. I should leave the decrees where they are. Okay. This must be from several years ago. In his divine benevolence, Mun reduces farmers' daily working hours from 14 to 13. Generous. From 2 years ago, the daily recitation of prayers is to be extended. Also, farmers who have attended the prayer for 7 consecutive days get 1 extra free hour in that week. Now he's really spoiling them. From last year, I think. Taxes reduced for literate members of the population, as they disproportionately contribute to the nation's intellectual wealth. People who are not literate, those being mostly farmers, will compensate for said reduction. Production is to be significantly increased in the forge. Matters of the nation's defense, apparently. Travel between the nation and the lands beyond is to be limited. A special permit is to be required to venture beyond the nation's borders. Those who do not obey will not be welcome back. A significant number of farmers are to be excused from their duties. Aha, good for them. As they are to be drafted to strengthen the defenses of the nation's outskirts. Oh. Thanks a lot, Mun. Okay, the poor farmers are getting... Okay, here's a lamp, here's some scrolls. Let's look at the lamp. Let's take a closer look. Holder, screw holder. Bulb. A suspiciously lever-shaped lamp holder. A silicon bulb that's very hot. And let's look at the holder. Oh, let's look at the screw. It holds the bulb in. It's screwed in tight. I wonder if... I mean, I've heard things of ancient libraries. It's worth a try. I can hear some hidden mechanism, but whatever it's supposed to trigger is not triggering. Okay. Might as well try all of them. And again, nothing happens. Still nothing. Yep. Okay, let's look at the engraving. Another image of Mun. He truly is omnipresent. What am I supposed to do with it? Okay. Scrolls. Another vase. Yet another decorative piece of pottery with Mun's face on it. Okay, is there like a... Reminds me of the missing plate from the Emperor's chamber. I wonder if there's like an order. Oh, what's this? At present, I see no reason to try to open it. Push the button. Push the button. Okay. Looks important. I wonder what is stored in there. Okay, so we've got some kind of order for the lamps. I'm pretty sure it's going to open this door. I mean, this looks very door-like. Secret door-like. Okay, let's... I mean, she just said the button looks important, but then doesn't want to touch it. Okay, let's talk to him. He strikes me as an intelligent man, very refined. Perhaps somehow too refined? I can't put my finger on it, but there's something insincere about the man. Something sneaky. Maybe there'll be a clue somewhere else as to what kind of order to pull those lamps in. Okay, so a few more places opened up. We've got the forge, temple, and the farms. Let's check out the forge first. Hey you, what in Mun's name? White, a vigilant sister? You must be Rutilus. A sister of Vigil, yes. I knew it. I saw your ship earlier. And you must be General Rutilus? In the flesh. At present in command of the Imperial Forces of Mun. What brings you to the city, sister? We are investing our time. Yes. Wisely. We are investing our time wisely. Brilliant. Aha. Investing. Understood. But don't worry, sister. I won't ask about the order's financial matters. But if you're looking to invest, you've come to the right place. What interests you here in the forge? Let's see. What do you think of the Emperor? What is your opinion of the God Emperor General? Mun be praised, a wise leader. Now I'll admit, there was a time not so long ago I may have spoken differently. But I couldn't be happier with his recent decrees. The might of the nation shall expand. That's why you're here to invest, am I right? Is there anything wrong with your eye, Master Rutilus? I was employing what we here in the city would call sly wink. Oh well, cultural differences. What do you do here in the forge? What do you do here in the forge, General Rutilus? We produce. Can you hear the heavy machinery? The chips buzzing? The wheels turning? I do? Then you've heard the heartbeat of the nation, sister. What does that machine over there do? Excuse me, General, but that machine over there, what's it for? You have a keen eye, sister. My personal invention and for my personal use only. A replication device. A replication device? Provide it with an original model and some material, and I will create a perfect physical copy. Can I use it? As I said, my personal use only. I really want to use your replication machine. I really need to use your replication device, Master Rutilus. Can't you make an exception for Vigilant Sister?
No.
A no was a no, sister. Okay. I must be on my way now. Understood. Feel free to inspect our forge for investment opportunities. That's pretty good. Okay, so we've got Rutilus. The general appears to be a serious man. In fact, he strikes me as somebody who cares a great deal about appearing serious. Well observed, Ava. Okay, we got a plug. Furnace. It's searing hot. It would burn my fingers off. And then we got a conveyor belt with some pieces on it. And so we got tools. A whole set of tools. A hammer, a chisel, and a screwdriver. Oh! Maybe General has used those recently? Maybe we could use the screwdriver on the screw for the lights. Could we take the tools? A handy collection of tools, a screwdriver, a hammer, and a chisel. Let's see if some of these can help me pierce the Emperor's suit. I'll borrow them. I'm sure the general wouldn't mind. It's for the good of the nation. Yes. Okay, so we have a machine. Sensor, text. It's not a touchscreen. It says I should lower my eye to the sensor. But since I'm not the general, I don't think that's a good idea. Yep. It wants to scan my eye. But since I'm not the general, I don't think that's a good idea. Okay. Okay, let's see. So we've got a screwdriver hammer, we got a chisel. I borrowed this chisel from the forge. It was lying on a table along with a hammer and screwdriver. Hammer I borrowed from the forge. It was lying on a table next to the chisel and screwdriver. And screwdriver. Screws or unscrew screws? What else can you say about a screwdriver? Maybe it's screwy? I don't know. Okay. We can go back to the library and try it on the lights, but first, let's take a look at the temple. Ooh. Statue. Greetings, you must be Master Catalyst. That would be Father Catalyst, sister. Pardon me, Reverend Father. Wait, so you address me sister, but I call you Father? Naturally, a sister vigil, yet you do not know the ways of the faith? Oh, I did know, I just suddenly found it. So God has been dead for less than a day and you're already going off the leash? Questioning customs? Focus and be respectful, acolyte. Yes, mother. I beg your... Father. I meant father. Oh, brother. Okay, tell me about this place. I've been admiring your temple, Father Catalyst. No doubt, it draws pilgrims from all corners of the nation. Is that why you're here, Vigilant Sister? One of the reasons, sure. And you've had a chance to observe our historical carvings? Much admired works of art. You may have read our Lord's story a thousand times, but there's something about seeing it depicted. Something that just inspires. And the statue. The holiest of holy in his classic contemplative pose, holding sunbeams that he has obtained from the sun itself. What do you think of the emperor? Oh, geez, obviously, I think he's very enamored with the emperor. What is your opinion of our divine lord, Father Catalyst? Opinion? Should one have opinions about his divine light, sister? I mean, certainly not. It is not my place to opine on the Lord. Only to pray. Of course, in thee. And I do pray. I pray his eternal wisdom allows him to halt the military expansion he's been planning. And here we have yet another roundabout way to say I don't like what Mun is doing. So lots of people not happy with Mun. What do you do here? Really? I think you might, like, throw me out one of the windows there. And what is your duty here, Father? I see you really have traveled from afar. I'm the head priest. I preside over all matters of faith and worship. But my role is obvious. Really, sister, it is you who could be more forthcoming as to your mission here. Well, I'm just visiting for pleasure. I'm on a holy pilgrimage. It's a secret. Mun is not a god, it's a man, and he's been murdered. Oh no, I'm not gonna say that. He definitely will kill me. Let's see, I'm on a holy pilgrimage, how about that? As an acolyte, it is my duty to travel to the Imperial City at least once in my training. And pay respect to the God Emperor. A sound reason. Yet I have not heard of this custom before. Uh-oh. And no other Vigilant Sisters in training have journeyed here in the past. Uh-oh. It's a new rule. Fine, sister, fine. I'll stop prying. I noticed one of the carvings is in a bad state. Say, Father Catalyst, the historical carving of Mun bringing light to the barbaric tribes. Say no more, sister. I am very much aware of its sore condition. I confess I've been putting the renovations off for too long. In fact, if you meet any skilled artisans, send them my way immediately. Will do, Father. I'll be on my way, Father Catalyst. May our divine Lord shine upon your path, sister. Okay, so nothing else. Let's look at the statue. A statue of Mun in meditation pose. He's holding 6 golden rods, which represent sunbeams. Okay, and then we got Catalyst, the head priest. He seems stern and somewhat solemn. More carvings. No doubt this is probably going to solve a puzzle later on. Not too sure what it represents yet. Is that a ship? And that kind of looks like the forge. And this looks like maybe the temple. Okay. So there's a mystery here. Okay, and then there's one here. We've got scrolls. And 3 wise men, maybe. And what's this one? Okay, so we've got light coming out of the tower. Let's see, what's this one? Okay, Mun dealing with beasts? I don't know what those are. Okay, we saw that one. And then we saw this one. Okay, so we've got Mun with rays of light. We got an inscription. Oh, we can read him. Okay, Mun, still one with the sun, creates the solar system with his breath of light. Okay. Let's go back and... Oops. Okay. Mun descends from the sun and brings light to the barbaric tribes of the great desert. Okay, so he came to enslave. Mun gives the Nath their trunks, letting them mine the depths of the desert for its sustenance. Did he cut them? Kind of looks like he... cut them in some way. Okay, the imperial city of his holy light is built. And Mun meditates while the sisters of vigil keep guard. Okay, so those are the sisters of vigil. Mun harnesses the power of the sun to create the nation's technology. Is there any carving on this? Nope. Okay, that looks like it's it for here. Okay, let's see. Forge, library, temple, Mun's chambers. Let's try the farms. Whoa. That's cool. Farmer, pottery, farming equipment, farming tools probably. I'm assuming they're tools and this is a farm. Can we take them? Oh, it said brilliant deduction. Shoot. I hope there wasn't more to that from the sister. Okay, that's some impressive craftsmanship. Whoever made this was good at what he does. I can't just take it. Okay. It probably belongs to the farmer. Ha! Funny hat. It's called a coif. Apologies. Funny coif. It's not that funny if you have to wear it all day in this climate. I can imagine. Anyways, you must be one of them nuns. What you call them? Ava, a sister vigil. Pleasure to meet you, sir. Plint. I am. How would you say of the agricultural creed? You're a farmer. Yeah, that. Let's see about the farms. This must be the strangest farm I've ever seen. Takes some getting used to, You gotta love the Nath. Ever since I first saw one, I wanted to become a farmer. you became a farmer? I thought people were born into it. That's how it goes these days. Not a good deal for anyone, if you ask me. Makes one wonder if things weren't better before. Before? You know, before Mun. But that's blasphemy. Might be, might be. It's true, though. First of all, that was eons ago. We're talking the dawn of humankind here, before history. Depends. Second, everyone knows it was a time of barbarity and chaos. Everybody knows. And they call them vigilant. Let me tell you, miss, if you hear the words, everybody knows, you can bet something really stupid is coming next. I like him. But you don't have to believe me. Ever heard of Hepicles? The lost writings of Hepicles? Not lost, just hidden away. If you manage to get your hands on those, you'll see for yourself. Noted. Now let's change the subject before we both get in trouble. Nice pottery collection. I must say I've been admiring your pottery collection. Thank you, miss. I wish I had more time to work on these. You made these? So a farmer and a potter. All kinds of crafts, miss. Nothing like working with your hands. I have a job for you. I have to go. Oh, let's send him over to the temple? Say, Master Plint, would renovating a historical carving be within your skill set? A carving? Aye, the one at the temple? So you know it. Oh yes, and you're right. Those carvings need a lot of renovating. Perfect. I'll be on it then. I'll ask Radina for permission. Wait, didn't you say you were going to ask for permission? Oh, I meant after I do it. That way I'll have negotiation leverage. What a strange man. We agree there. Okay. So, calling into question the whole of Mun's reign, I guess. Let's go over here. Got a tree. A Gnath tree, like the one I saw in Mun's chamber, but this one is fully grown. Pretty short tree. People wouldn't survive here for long without these plants. They have so many uses. Let's see, we got a Gnath. Oh, and there's Radina. Okay, we got a knife. Ooh, a knife. A knife stuck in a Gnath fruit. Thoughts, Ava? Well, what if this was the murder weapon, Mother Superior? I know it's a stretch, but this here must be the Lady Radina, the chief agriculturist Master Xavian spoke of. Which makes her a very important, powerful person. One of the very few who had access to the Imperial Palace. And she just so happens to own a knife, which would match the Emperor's wound rather well. Yes. Yes? Yes, it is a stretch. I should have seen that coming. I'm not saying it's not possible. You're right that the knife matches the wound. So I say you follow your hunt, Cheva. There is, of course, still a question of piercing the suit. But the knife could be a place to start. So I may be right. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. Okay. Let's talk to Radina. Good day to you. Lady Radina? You must be Lady Radina. I don't mean to disturb, but... Yes. Excuse me? Yes, the name's Radina. And you are? Ava, pleased to make your acquaintance. A vigilant nun, huh? We prefer sister. See, nuns are cloistered, while sisters... And what is your business here, sister? Now watch your tongue this time, acolyte. I know. You know what? Nothing. You know nothing. Well, yes, actually. Maybe you can help me with that. What do you think of the Emperor? What are these creatures? Is this your knife? About Plint. Okay, what do you think of the Emperor? You seem angry, Lady Radina. Perhaps his holy light has not been shining at you lately, hmm? I'm not angry, none. Just worried. Worried about? Lately, our god has been ambitious. The fire and brimstone kind of ambitious. And the outlines, they don't forget. She thinks Mun was provoking a war. The recent decree suggested so, too. Now, is that enough of a motive to kill your god? What are these creatures? These creatures, what are they? Ah, the Nath. Aren't they majestic? Their trunks reach deep into the soil. We've built grand palaces and ships and terrifying weapons. But we still can't get sustenance from this dry land. The Nath can. It makes their skin fertile. So we take advantage of that and grow our food on their backs. Nath burgers. In a way, we are parasites. Is this your knife? Apologies, but is this your knife? It was my knife. Until some poor soul decided to borrow it and cut an unripe Nath fruit with it. Now it's ruined. Borrowed? You say someone borrowed your knife? Maybe. Or maybe the knife decided to cut the fruit all by itself. All I know is I sure didn't stick it in there. So who do you think did it? Good question, but I don't have an answer for you, Nun. One thing is certain. My farmers aren't stupid. Nobody here would try to cut an unripe Nath fruit. Unless they did it on purpose. Ha, good one. But no, my farmers aren't suicidal either. Let's see, ruined. Why would the knife be ruined? By Mun, you really know nothing. Unripe Nath juice is a powerful adhesive. The knife is no use to me now. Can I take the knife? So if the knife is ruined, then you wouldn't mind if I took it? A strange request. Why does the knife interest you so much anyway, Nun? I believe it's a murder weapon. I think I can get it unstuck. I just like it. I think I might be able to get it unstuck. Ha, good luck with that. So can I can take it? Fine, fine, it's yours. As I said, it's no use to me anymore. Thank you. Let's see, about Plint. Your farmer, Master Plint. Oh no, not again. What has he done this time? On second thought, don't tell me. I have no patience for petty problems anymore. Just leave the man alone, will you? I didn't... Look, Nun, he doesn't know what he's saying. You cannot blaspheme if you're not right in the head. So I won't hear any more of it. But I wasn't... Enough! Plint is under my protection. Make your peace with it. I will make my peace with it then, whatever it is. She seems accustomed to complaints about the farmer's manners. Why would she protect him, I wonder? Maybe it's her son. That will be it for now. So you shall. Okay, so let's look at Radina. This is Radina. She runs into Nath Farms. She seems angry, or maybe just suspicious of outsiders. In any case, there's something hostile about her. When you see them from this far away, you almost feel you could pet them. Almost. Okay, so can we take a... I don't need to pick fruit off the tree. There's plenty that's already been harvested. I wonder, would Master Plint mind if I took some fruit? I don't think so. I mean, the harvest seems to be plentiful this year. I'm sure they have more fruit than they know what to do with. In fact, it would be considerate of me to take more. Say 3. To relieve them of their burden. Ah, the power of rationalization. What was that? Oh, nothing. Never mind me, Ava. Oof, these are heavy. Okay, so we got... Nath fruit. We got a knife and fruit. It's Radina's knife. It got glued to an unripe Nath fruit. some nath fruit I got from the farmer. They're heavy. Okay. Let's see. Okay, let's see if we can go back to the archives, and then let's use that screwdriver on the light. Let's see if that helps open whatever it is we're opening. Okay, let's try the library. And let's go look at the lamp. Nope. Let's take a closer look. Okay, let's use the screwdriver on the screw. It's loose, I don't need to meddle with it anymore. Okay, can we take out the bulb? I should use that on the screws, not the bulb. Okay. I try to take it out, but it's held in by two screws. Okay. Oh, there we go. And this one here. Okay. I'll remove the bulb. Okay. Ooh, I wonder if we can put the nath in there. All right, this should keep it down. Ooh. Okay. Let's do the same with all the others. I keep left clicking it by accident. Okay, let's use the screwdriver. Let's do it faster this time. Okay, good. So we figured out the puzzle, it'll help us out. All right, it should keep us down. Okay, let's look at the last one. I love it how it speeds through it for you. That's cool. Okay, is there one more? Oh, there is one more. But we have... Oh, maybe we can put the knife and fruit in there. Oh, we didn't have to. We just had to hold it down. Okay, I knew it. A secret passage right there. Aha, the plot thickens. What are you waiting for, Ava? Let's go. That was a cool puzzle. I mean, I kind of knew that you had to do it, but it's still pretty cool. What is this place? Okay, it's Mun in his contemplative pose, exactly like the statue at the temple. But wait, the statue was holding 6 beams. But here, Mun is holding 7. So now we have a sunbeam theft? Maybe the engraving just doesn't match the statue. I should ask the head priest about it. Okay, so it looks like he's holding fries, really. Okay, scales. So we have to use something on the scales. What do we have here? Okay, we got a weighing pen. Okay, what happens if they're equal? I will put everything back the way I found it. Okay. Come on, Ava. It's a bronze weighing pen. In it, there's looks like a ceramic shard. Okay, can we put our knife and fruit in there? I don't need to weigh that. Okay. They look like pizza slices. In it, there are two. It looks like ceramic shards. Okay. Dais. It's a stone dais. Okay, so it goes back automatically. Alright, so all we have here is some scales and an image. There's 7 golden rods, but the statue at the temple is only holding 6. I should ask the head priest about it. Okay. Anything else lying around here? Are you sure you're done examining this place, Ava? It's not like you can walk in and out of the secret passage whenever you please. True, but what more is there to see here? The ceramic shards on the scales, it may be the key to everything. You need to take a better look at them. Maybe if I laid them on the dais, I could see more clearly. Good thinking. Oh, they're plates. Okay, let's check it out. It's a plate. But is this the... The missing plate. Didn't I say the plate was important? And so the plot begins to unravel, no? Yes, I think I can see it now. See what? This only makes things more confusing. Oh, come on, Acolyte, isn't it obvious? Well, I think. The scales are a puzzle. The killer stole the plate. The killer broke the plate and wanted to hide it. Okay. It's a puzzle. If we put the right shards on the right side of the scales... I don't know. Another secret passage will open? Now we just have to find the clue. The clue. You know, like, two weigh more than one, but three are less than a quarter of 12. And we place the shards on the scales the right way, and voila. Aha, so somebody constructed a secret door and rigged it to a scale. And it can only be opened using broken pieces of a dead god's decoration piece. Oh well, when you say it like that... Okay, the killer stole the plate. The killer must have stolen the plate. Maybe it's a little souvenir, huh? And then they broke it and decided to weigh it. Okay. Well, maybe they want to sell it and are estimating the cost? Well, I do give you points for imagination. I know. The killer broke the plate by accident and didn't want to leave traces. Why not just throw it off the balcony? And why the scales? I give up. It's a mystery to me. I'll agree that some aspects of this are still rather unclear. Like the number. Why four? Four what? Four shards. Three on one side, one on the other. Where is the fifth shard? Yes, I noticed that too. One piece of the plate is missing. Indeed, and before it resurfaces, we won't know everything. Oh well, all in due time. I'll let you proceed with your mission, Acolyte. We still have a murder to reconstruct. Yes, Mother Superior. Okay. So there probably was already a clue somewhere. Will it let us leave? I think I've done all I could here. Yes, yes. This place, if I'm not mistaken, it's at the center of everything. But for the time being, there's nothing more for us to do here. As cryptic as ever. So that was that. Now let me quickly... Right, I'll put everything else back as well. Done. Okay, we got the screwdriver, we got the nath fruit. Okay, so now we're on the lookout for that extra plate piece. Let's see, maybe Xavier has something to say. Where can I find the writings? This is the best library in the whole nation, yes? Yes, sister, proud to confirm that. Then do you have, per any chance, anything by somebody named Hippocles? Notice this man's pupils, Acolyte. That's what fear looks like. Do not worry, Master Xavian. Mother Superior sent me to retrieve the scroll. Did I now? You can speak freely. Well, in such case, yes, we do in fact possess the lost writings of Hippocles. But they are beyond my reach, vigilant sister. Securely stored in the Emperor's vault. Only his divine light can grant you access. His divine light is in no condition to grant anything. So how do I get to it? I am of no help here, sister. Your sister vigil, Ava. You need no help. Okay, we can use the thing. Thank you, Mr. Xavier. That will be all for... I'm surprised I didn't use it or try and use it already. Okay. Let's try and use our crystal on the vault. That's right. No door stays closed to a sister of vigil. Now, how do I... Look at the lock. Stare at it. Right. Now close your eyes quickly. And the image that's been burned into your retina. Picture it unlocking. It worked. Okay, grab the scroll. The lost writings of Hippocles. So the crazy farmer was right after all. I wish I had more time to study this. Now let me close the vault again. Okay. The last writings of Hippocles, highly sacrilegious and until recently believed to be lost forever. The text speaks of a nation before Mun, one from which I can tell was anything but barbaric, and which we can assume was extinguished by Mun and his armies. Interesting. Let's see, do we ask Savine about it? Or let's go to the temple. Oh, he's there already. Hello, Master Plint. Master Plint. Howdy, miss. Apologies. I have to be on my way. Sure. See you around, miss. Father Catalyst. May I have a word with you again? A brief word, sister, yes. One gold rod is missing the statue. Your stork carvings are wrong. Oh. I've seen an image of Mun similar to the statue of here. In many places, no doubt, it is a popular pose. Mun holding the 7 sunbeams. That's the problem. Your statue is only holding 6. Impossible. The statue, like all its counterparts, is holding 7 golden rods. Just count them. This is preposterous. 1, 2, 6. By his fiery gaze, you're right. The temple has been desecrated. So you think somebody has stolen the rod? What other explanation is there? The statue was definitely holding 7 rods. But the wretched thief is in for a surprise. Good luck to him selling madman's gold. Madman's gold? Oh yes, see, we've had cases like this in the past. Too many golden ornaments going missing. And so, for several decades now, statues are adorned exclusively with madman's gold. He's talking about pleuronite. Pleuronite? I see you're a well-read sister. Yes, pleuronite. Pleuronite. So, what does this what does it do? It simply disappears. The air in this temple is carefully maintained to make golden rods solid. But once outside the building, they will disappear without a trace within a few days. Without a trace, you say? Without a trace. Indeed. Your historical carvings, Father Catalyst. They say Mun brought light to the desert tribes, correct? They are not my carvings, sister. That is simply history as it took place. Well, have you heard of the lost writings of Hippocles? Oh, please, sister. Only madmen and blasphemers concern themselves with such fairy tales. So what if I told you that... Speak of it no more. This is a sacred place. But... Enough. Those documents do not exist and never have. Unless you can show it to me directly, I will hear no more of it. About the last writings of Hippocles. Have I not made myself clear? Either hand me said writings or stay silent. Okay, what happens if I give it? I'll be on my way. May our divine lord shine upon your path, sister. Okay, what happens if we give him the scroll? I can almost hear the wheels in your head spinning, acolyte. Mother Tiabata, did you hear? A rod has been stolen from the temple recently. Made of madman's gold. A metal which just happens to evaporate without a trace. So you're thinking. Murder weapon. I mean, we still don't know how the suit was pierced. But at least we have an idea where the weapon went. It simply evaporated. Good job, Ava. Good job. Thank you, Mother Superior. Now, once you've obtained a rod yourself... Wait. What do you mean, obtained a rod yourself? I'm confused, acolyte. Are there more ways to interpret what I said? Wait, you surely don't want me to desecrate Mun's statue. Oh, so you see other options. Well, I'm listening. Why do I have to physically do it anyway? Replicate the murder, I mean. Surely a solid theory is enough. No theory is as solid as a practical demonstration. How better understand our killer than to walk a mile in their shoes? Easy for you to say when it's me who has to do the walking. Okay, how about if it is really necessary to desecrate Mun's temple, then maybe you would prefer to do it yourself. Prefer, perhaps. I must admit I'd find some entertainment in that. Alas, I tend to draw attention. You, on the other hand, are... And here comes the casual insults. Don't bother, Mother Superior. I've heard it all. This is new. What is new? The tone. The defiance. I'm sorry, Mother Tiabata. I would recite the Litany of Penitence, But it seems rather silly now, doesn't it? Yes. I'd be praying to a suit. I've been praying to a suit my whole life. Yet you don't want to desecrate the suit's statue. I don't. That would be chaos. I know this doesn't make any sense to you, but... It makes perfect sense. A hard thing to shake, Faith. So, look, Ava, if it helps... I'm hereby directly ordering you to steal the golden rod. As per your oath to the Order Vigil, you have no choice but to obey. Feel better now? Yes, Mother Superior. Then that's settled. Now get to it. You have a temple heist to perform. And a murder weapon to fashion. Okay, maybe we need to bring it to the forge. And use the chisel on it. Okay, let's... I just can't break the rod off with my bare hands. Okay, first, let's try and give the scroll to Catalyst. Father Catalyst, look what I found. But this is... Yes, a cheap forgery. I assure you it's not. Let me see. Oh, well, I stand corrected. It is a good forgery. Let me study it for some time and I'll prove it to you. Oh, he's gonna burn it. Be my guest. Okay, but maybe we can steal it while he's busy with that. Let's see, squeeze a hammer. Oof, right. Let me just casually walk over here to admire the statue. And... It's done. Let's be off. Miss. What? What? Who? Nothing like doing some honest work with a hammer and chisel. I? What do you mean? I wasn't... Oh. You're talking about your hammer and chisel. What else? Look, the job's done. I see Plint also updated the inscription. Mun lights up the ancient nations of the Great Desert. So basically burning them all. Interesting. Master Plint's interpretation of Mun bringing light to the barbaric tribes. Boy, he's going to be in trouble. Not so long ago, I would have been terribly upset about this. Now I don't know what to think anymore. Okay, well, that's an original interpretation of the event, Master Plint. You certainly put your own spin on it. Well, I looked at the other ones and figured... This is a place where they like to get creative with history. So I went all in. What do you think? I think you're a blasphemer and a heretic. I'm just not sure anymore if that's a bad thing. I'll take that as a compliment, miss. My work, it may be a little allegorical. But it's closer to the truth than the other ones, I'll tell you that. Have you read the writings of Hippocles? Alas, I was very busy, Master Plint. Oh, we read them. And now Father Catalyst has them. That's a shame. We've got a lot to learn from the pre-Mun era. The art, the pottery, they even had... Master Plint, please remind me. Is the great Mun paying you to work or to talk? I'm all done, sir. Come take a look. Uh-oh. Oh, marvelous. The temple restored to its full glory. Let me just finish this short passage and I will be with you, Master Craftsman. Let's get out of here. I don't want to be around for this. I better go. See you, Master Plant. He's totally dead. That's just so spooky. Oh. Plint is back here. Master Plint, you're back. I have to say, I was a little worried about you. That's nice of you, miss, but there's no need. I've known Catalyst for a while. Man's a professional. What do you mean? I mean, he knows the whole zealotry thing is his job. And he makes sure to do it well. But at the end of the day, he just wants to put his feet up and have some peace. And he knows Radina has a soft spot for me. I'll just avoid him for a while and things will be fine. Well, I'm glad you're in good spirits. It was good talking to you, Master Plint. See you around, miss. Okay, farm equipment, pottery. I guess there's like no pieces of plate around. If I may, Lady Radina, I thought nuns were of the quiet, contemplative sort. Yet you talk and talk and talk about Plint. You don't give up easily, do you? Whatever you think he should be punished for, just leave it. I shall be on my way now, so you shall. Let's see, can we give her anything? Separate. Oh, maybe we can separate the knife and the forge. Let's go back. Maybe that's one way to do this. And fruit? Let me see. Oh, we can. Okay, good. It's working. The heat is softening the glue. I've managed to free the knife. I'll keep the sticky nath fruit too. Okay. Let's see. So we have the knife, the madman's gold. It's Radina's steel knife. Could this have been the murder weapon? An unarmed nath fruit. Its juice is extremely sticky. Let's see, what if we combine the madman's gold with it? Before I start filling with gold, I need to shape it into something that resembles a weapon. Okay, so I was right. Could we replicate? Let's see, could we, like... We need, like, what if we use the amulet? Darn. We need to replicate the knife with the gold. I think that's the idea. Master Rutilus. Yes, sister? I really need to use replication device, Master Rutilus. Can't you make an exception for Jinlin's sister? No is a no. Okay, there's gotta be... Oh, maybe I can give him the gold. Darn. Okay. There's no mirror or anything. How do we get him over here to look at the machine? Let's see, what are we gluing here? Oh, let's see if the amulet can get me access. It worked. Oh, that's cool. Okay. So let's put the knife in. Now it wants me to provide material for the new knife. Of course, the gold. Very cool. It worked. Done. Are you watching, Mr. Tiabata? I think I've got the murder weapon. Crash. What was that, Mr. Tiabata? Ah, yes, the murder weapon. Good, good. You're ready to reconstruct the crime, then? Yep, let's get over there. Shatter. Did I just hear something break? What are you doing, Mother Superior? Oh, nothing. Just never mind. Proceed with your task. Okay, she's breaking plates, I think. Strange. Okay, let's go. Let's get up there. Yeah, I knew it. Breaking plates. Mother Tiabata. What happened here? Are those the plates? Mother Superior, what is this? What have you done? An experiment. I just needed to confirm. An experiment? I'll regret saying this, but... Have you gone mad? First the statue, and now... I thought we settled the statue question. We settled it? You just ordered me. You made it abundantly clear I had no choice, remember? That's the nature of our arrangement, Acolyte. You made your choice when you entered the order. Because I thought we solved problems because of... Oh, how about... Because I was told that we solved problems. Sometimes we do. Do we really? Because so far, all I've seen us do, all you've made me do, is lie and break things. All for the sake of, well, this, the biggest lie of them all. Hmm. Well, Acolyte. Yes. Guess what? Yes, I suppose you're right. Oh. And? And what? There's a butt coming. Or, you know, one of those little tricks. Where you're right ends up meaning you're stupid. On the contrary, what you say is true, plain and simple. You, just like many before you, have been methodically fed a lie. And it has been my duty to take part in the feeding. Right. So, I'm listening. Curses, I'm not used to being right. One of your rare virtues. That's it then? We keep pretending? Ah, I once stood where you stand, Ava. Things may have been a little easier for me, I'll admit. I was never much of a believer to begin with, so by the time they finally told me, I'd already formed a solid theory of Mun's true nature. Of course. Still, though, to have it confirmed, the bold-faced admission of the whole charade. Let's just say I'm not entirely unsympathetic. Why go along with it, then? Two reasons. One simple, one slightly less so. Let's see. What's the simple reason? I simply don't have the power to do much else. The Sisters of Vigil are granted a great deal of privilege. But when it comes to the oath of secrecy, the Mun dynasty has always been swift and merciless. And the less simple one? Just be a vigilant sister a little longer and observe yourself, Acolyte. For more than a decade, I've known you as exceptionally mild-mannered and obedient. And yet here you are, arms folded, righteous fury personified. So? I mean, it was about time. It was. Once again, we agree. But if toppling the Mun myth does this to you, what do you expect from others? The nation numbers in millions. All manner of people, and much of that manner far from mild. The inconvenient truth is, under Mun, we have enjoyed centuries of relative peace. Now, I may sometimes break the small things. Plates, statues. But nations, beliefs? Try that, and you may come to discover that the one thing worse than Mun is a Mun-shaped hole. Interesting. I still don't understand. How can you do what you do, knowing everything about Mun is fake? How could I do what I do not knowing that? this moment, Ava, when we find out. Not everyone handles it well, but the ones of us who do. It makes us vigilant, I mean. I'm not sure I'm following. Did you ever really think Mun used to be the sun? And then he just exhaled light and that somehow became planets and people and whatnot? After he did that, this all-powerful, adept, and endlessly wise being decided the best thing to do next was to take over one nation on one planet and issue petty decrees once in a while? I suppose I don't know what I thought. Those were just details. Exactly. It's all in the details. The truth was staring you in the face the whole time. You just chose to not connect the dots. It's a mistake we all make once and then never want to make again. And so we listen. We observe. We ask questions. And every now and then we end up solving problems. I think I understand. I understand. Good. Now, shall we address the corpse in the room for a change? After all, there's still a murderer on the loose. And while I was engaging in a bit of sacrilegious vandalism, I believe you have been hatching a theory of your own. Well, yes, I think I have an idea. Maybe I know how the stabbing could have been done. Fantastic. I shall eagerly await a demonstration. What are you waiting for? Get to it, Acolyte. Let's see. Do we climb into the suit? I just need to do anything with it. Just okay. Right, we wouldn't want to contaminate the crime scene. Okay. Let's see. Golden knife. Let's see. Do we close up the suit? Is it somehow the rod? Okay, what do we do here? I mean, can't we just get into it? Okay. Let's see. Golden knife. It fits perfectly. Mystery of the closed suit solved. Well, almost. Right now the knife is just loosely hanging on the latch. Oh. Okay, we have to use the glue. Okay, so then as soon as he uses the latch to close himself up, it twists the thing up and then stabs him. Okay. And then it disappears. Let's see, something around here. A plant? How about the Emperor? Okay, well, what could we use as a body? Pots? Pillows? Yes, those could work. Let's do this. Okay, here we go. And so I glued the knife to the lid, and I think it's gonna work. I see. Well, ready when you are, Acolyte. Right, right. Here goes. I think it worked. Let's open the suit and confirm. Moment of truth, then. Ah. And that is how you pierce an impenetrable suit. By putting the blade inside to begin with. Exactly. I have to say, that's rather clever. Isn't it? But why didn't we find any weapon in the suit then, you may wonder? I was wondering just that. Tell me, Acolyte. Gladly. See, there's this material known as Madman's Gold. And if you're a sister learned in the sciences like me, you will surely know that said material evaporates without a trace. Genius. I know. See, isn't this fun, Ava? Congratulations to your first successful crime reconstruction. You would make a decent murderer. Thank you, I suppose. Anyway, the time has come. I hope it's clear now why it was crucial to reconstruct the crime. To have fun? To determine who the killer is. Over the past day, you've walked in the murderer's footsteps, Ava. You've done what they have done. The obstacles you had to overcome, they had to grapple with those too. So there's nobody more qualified than you to answer the question. Who did it? I have to think about it, my superior. Oh please, Acolyte, let's not stall any longer. This poor man lying on the floor, who is responsible for his fate? Is it the Mother Superior? Let's see. Xavier the Scholar. Let's see, he knew the agriculturist, the priest, the general, the farmer, the mystery judge. I mean, we never saw Maris, so it's hard to tell. I mean, it makes the most sense because he's not there. Plint? No. He's crazy and he knows a lot, but I don't think he'd kill anyone. Rudeless? No. But he's the only one that could create the weapon. I mean, they kind of all did it, it feels like. Because only we can use our thing. But the general is the only one who can use the replication machine. General Rudeless, definitely. Was that improving him? Lay out your evidence, Acolyte. First of all, the replication machine. If I could obtain Radina's knife and some fruit glue and Madman's Gold, then so could the killer. Anyone could have done those things. Not that it was easy, but it could be done. Now that was definitely proving. Continue, please. Well, so everything was doable by anyone, except for the machine. I got access to the general's machine only thanks to the amulet of Vigil. Which means that only the general or Sister Vigil could have made the golden knife. So unless you killed the Emperor, Mother Tiabata, it must have been the general. Excellent, Ava. Even the tools I used to steal the Madman's Gold. They belong to the general. Not that it proves anything by itself, but it adds to the full picture, no? I have to say, I am... what is the word? Impressed. It feels so strange on my lips. Wait, so that's it? General Rudeless is our killer? Yes, Ava, I am strongly convinced he is. So, mystery solved. The easy part of it, sure. So then, wait, what? The easy part? Of course, finding the killer was never what concerned me most. But what could be more important than that? Oh, Ava. You mean you still don't see it? See what? You lament a statue, you agonize over some broken pottery. And yet you don't see the cracks in, well, everything else. I think it's her. I think she did it. What cracks? Whatever do you mean, Mother? Everything. Just follow the thread from the start. The suit. The body. The missing plate. The lamps. The decrees. The lost writings of Hippocles. The scales. And at the center of it all... 5 shards, 4 accounted for, 3 on one side, 1 on the other. So 3 of them? I really have no idea what you're talking about, Master Tiabata. Mother Tiabata. Well, I'm sure General Rulis will be kind enough to enlighten us both. Go fetch him, will you? Tell him. Yes, tell him I'm interested in making some serious investments. Are you sure, Mother Superior? We're dealing with a killer here. Shouldn't we summon the guards? Oh no, anything but that. What the general has to say is for our ears only. Don't worry about it, the man is a buffoon. We just need to apply the right kind of pressure in the right places. I tend to be rather good at applying pressure. Can't argue with that. Very well then, Mother Tiabata. I shall summon the general. Okay. Dead, of course. General Rudolus. Mother Tiabata, do you see that? Is he? Only one way to find out, Acolyte. He's dead as a doornail. By mine, he's dead. Curses, I should have anticipated this. But ow, I thought he was the killer. Search the body, Ava. The last dot we need to connect. It is here, I'm sure of it. Okay, face. Hand. Strange object. What is that in his pocket? I think you already know, Acolyte. It's the shard. Let's take it out and get a better look. Is that? It sure is. The shard. The pizza. The last shard. And so now we know everything. What do you mean, everything? I thought the general killed the emperor, but now somebody killed him. And the secret passage and the plate and... Isn't it obvious? No, it's not obvious. It's not obvious at all. Just tell me what's going on. Very well, then. Find the 3 remaining leaders and ask them to gather at the library. Tell them that I sent you and that it is urgent. Are you sure? Last time you sent me to fetch someone, I found a dead body. I assure you there will be no more dead bodies. I'll be with you shortly and explain everything. But before that, I have one brief errand to run. What errand? What could be more pressing than this? Where are you going, Mother Tiabata? The farms. Yes, it's time I finally paid a visit to the farms. Okay. So we automatically gathered them all, which is great. Okay, here we go. Here's the Hercule Poirot reveal. Vigilant Mother Superior, we've been eagerly awaiting. An explanation, an apology even. Has the Acolyte confessed to you about... Pleasure to make your acquaintance, Father Catalyst. The desecration of Endor's Lady Radina. A pleasure to meet you again, Master Xavian. I've gathered you all here to discuss an extremely pressing matter. Now I'm certain your time is as precious as mine. So let us get straight to the point, shall we? Yes, let's. What is this about, and where is Rudolus? Interesting, you shouldn't also inquire about Judge Maris, Lady Radina. But as I said, let us not waste time. Earlier today, me and Sister Ava were summoned by His Holy Light. Upon entering the secret chamber, we made a rather startling discovery. Well, that music is really loud. A discovery, please do share, my vigilant mother. Ava, you've been itching to speak out the whole time. Well, this is your moment. Tell them what we discovered, will you? What? What do you mean, Mother Tiabata? Just tell them. Mun is not pleased with the state of the library. Mun is happy to... Mun is not a god, it's a man, and he's dead, murdered. Mun is not... Oh, spit it out already, Akalik. I'm waiting for you to stop me. Like you always do. We're past that now. Really? Really, go on. Do not be afraid. Mun is not... He isn't. Mun isn't a god. He's not omnipotent. He's not all-knowing. And he definitely isn't immortal. It's just a man in a mechanical suit. It's always been a man in a mechanical suit. And he's been murdered. He's dead. Mun is fake and also dead. There you go. Cathartic? Terrifying. Oh. Eh. Hmm. Why is no one else having a heart attack right now? Did you hear me? Mun is... They know Ava. They have known for quite some time. All of them? All of them. Am I the only one in this nation? Now, let us not get distracted. I don't know what the two of you are speaking of. But I have to say I'm deeply appalled by... Oh, yes, appalled. This is black. And they're catching on now. Blah. Listen, you lot, this is how things will go. I know that you know, and you know that I know that you know. You get the gist. It's knowing all the way down. Blah. And yet you're wondering, who else might be listening? Is this a test? What will she report to the Order? How will this gathering go down in history, and what do I want to be quoted saying? I understand, but I have a complicated case to unravel. And I would prefer to do that without constant exclamations of blasphemy and sacrilege and whatnot. I'm looking at you, Father Catalyst. Blah! So now's your time. You will make your devotion to Mun known. You will express your shock and disgust and purge it, as they say, out of your system. And then you will let me speak, uninterrupted. Blasphemy, heresy. Yes, Father Catalyst, preach the truth. This is heinous, the most sinful of words my ears have had to endure. Sacrilege. Let it be heard that I refuse to take any part in this. Lady Redina, I'm good. Marvelous. Now where were we? Ah yes, the Emperor's Chamber. Upon our entrance, we are met with a mechanical suit, and within the suit, a dead body. And at this point, I have to say, even I am taken aback. I see an extremely concerning situation, and I know I have to delegate, as poor Sister Ava here had just a crisis of faith land on her plate. I decided to give her the easier task of reconstructing the murder and revealing the identity of the killer. Thank you. I meanwhile concern myself with another identity. The identity of the victim. I assume you all recognize this man. Oh no. Maurus. Radina, don't... Oh, give it up already, Xavian. She knows. That's right. Do you then, Lady Radina, identify this man as Judge Maurus? What? Yes, I do, dammit. This here is the late judge. So this isn't Mun? And you knew the whole time? From the first moment I saw the body, yes. Of course, you knew what the Emperor looked like. I'd never seen the Emperor in my life. So you recognized the judge? No, I didn't know what the judge looked like either. Upon arrival, I thought it was Master Xavian, remember? But then how? Come on, Ava, you examined the body, did you not? I didn't notice anything. Oh, but you did notice. In fact, I noticed you noticing to an inappropriate degree. The muscles, Ava. Didn't I clearly tell you emperors are entirely reliant on the suit? That most of them can barely walk? Granted, there are Muns who manage to stay somewhat physically active. But nobody can maintain this kind of physique if they spend most of their days in a metallic coffin. Oh. Now put yourself in my shoes. I'm summoned to meet the Emperor, and lo and behold, there is a different man in the suit. And this is really loud. My mind starts racing. What is happening here? Has Mun's secret been revealed? At least two people must know of the suit, the victim and the killer. And if two people know, then how many others? I still maintain I don't know. I said no interruptions, Master Xavius. Anyways, I was very much in the dark at this point, grasping at straws. But then Ava made a discovery. A secret passage opened by four levers. Four! Wait, what does the number of levers have to do with anything? You can't be serious now, Acolyte. Why did you think there were four levers? Because there's four of them. I thought it was, you know, a puzzle. And what is it with you and puzzles? The passage was obviously meant to be opened by four people. And within the passage, a plate split into five perfectly even pieces. Most of it clicked for me at this point. 5 liters, 5 shards. 4 levers to open the passage, 4 shards on the scales. 3 on one side, 2 on the other. Wait. I understand all these numbers. They're important to you, Mother, but... You skipped the biggest question of all. Which is, if the dead man is Judge Maris, then where is the God Emperor? There is no God Emperor, Ava. Fine, I know he's not a god, but... You misunderstand. There is no emperor at all, god or man. There hasn't been one for a while now. What? Let me explain. When I saw the split plate, and looked at the pottery in the emperor's chamber, a narrative entered my mind, a strange yet surprisingly plausible tale. A tale which I have since been able to confirm. Let me relate it to you now and hopefully things will become finally clear. Oh boy. This is a long reveal. At some rather distant point in the past, the latest Mun reads the last writings of Hepicles. And this latest Mun, he's an odd one. What his predecessors considered a threat, he sees as inspiration, hope, a potential for change. Our Mun, he's been watching the cracks in the system with concern. And so he decides if the plate is to be broken, better do it cleanly. Sometime later, the 5 leaders of the city are summoned to the Emperor's chamber. Inside, they find an empty suit. A set of instructions heavily inspired by the pre-Mun era. And a ceramic plate split into 5 even pieces. From now on, they're to take turns in the suit, assuring a balance of interests. And as further assurance, should the current ruler be deemed unfit, the others can vote him out of, well, out of suit. So the shards. Yes, Ava, the shards are votes. And it's very ancient custom. You really should have taken some time to read Hepicles. In his time, people were sometimes given the opportunity to vote. To make choices. Okay. In the desert, parchment was almost everything was scarce. But the one thing everyone had too much of was broken pottery. And so they used it to make their voices heard. They used it to vote. As a Hepicles devotee, our emperor simply couldn't resist the symbolism. So that's why you're obsessing over the numbers. Yes, I knew that 4 people voted and 1 was excluded. So I assumed a decision was probably made about the 5th person. But who was the odd one out? What exactly was this whole kerfuffle about? Aha. I'm sure you can see the rest of the story now. For a time, a balance is struck. We help the farmers a little 1 year. Support the church on the next. And then for a change, we prop up the intellectual elite. But then, Rudolus takes charge. And the decrees don't stop coming. And suddenly war is imminent. So that's why Rudolus was the only one who was genuinely fond of Mun. Because when he spoke of Mun's latest decisions, he was really talking about himself. And so the time comes. To finally use the shards. The 4 remaining leaders vote. and the general is informed that he is to be replaced by the judge. But here's the problem. The mun-shaped hole is still very much there. And it sucks people like Rudolph in with irresistible force. So the general, he is not going to go peacefully. And now you have to understand General Rudolph. He was a man of a very narrow form of intelligence. A man surprisingly clever in mechanical matters. Yet unaware of the fact that you don't explain a sly wink. When such a man thinks of murder, he thinks in terms of its technical execution. He believes he's being devious when he uses Radina's knife. And that he's straight out genius when he devises a disappearing murder weapon. And yet he doesn't see that the remaining leaders will obviously know he did it. Because who else really? He doesn't realize that if you want a formal trial, you shouldn't kill the judge. And so on his last day as Mun, the general sets his little trap, and his successor, the judge, is murdered the moment he replaces him in the suit. The remaining leaders are confused at first, a matter not made easier by our sudden presence. But they, you, masters and lady, you soon catch on to what has occurred. You corner Rudolus, apply the right pressure and heat in the right places. You get a confession, and as far as you're concerned, justice is served. Isn't it beautiful, Ava? The respectful silence. And they say people don't learn. Well, vigilant Mother Superior, I believe I speak for everyone. Everyone. When I say that this is the most ridiculous pile of hogwash I've ever heard. I say, I've read of this condition, a very particular type of paranoia, that forces one to perceive patterns everywhere, and so one becomes obsessive. Counting lamps, pottery pieces, who knows what else. The worst kind of delusions can stem from this type of mental malaise. I must admire your persistence, Master Xavian. And I've always been one to respect the demand for direct evidence. Therefore, please allow me to call upon my key witness. Fools, murderers, hear the word of Mun. I've entrusted you with a nation to rule. Yet within four orbits of the sun, you succumb to petty violence? For your sins, you shall be judged. Ha, still got it. Masters and ladies, let me introduce you to Keem, who illuminates the darkest of souls, the original creator and the final destroyer. The son of the sun and the master of time, his holy light, God Emperor Mun. Howdy. Yee. Blah. I knew it. That's it. I'm officially dead inside. Nothing can surprise me anymore. I bow before thee, oh. Shut it, Xavian. You've made a fine mess of things, haven't you? I hand you a nation on a plate. And it takes you less than 5 years to start going at each other's throats. Pardon me, your holy light, but what did you expect? Their whole life, they've been conditioned to believe. Right, I know. A me-shaped hole and all that. Well, we'll sort things out now, don't you worry. But first I gotta ask, Miss Tiabata. What gave me away? Oh, please, final destroyer. The Hippocles text, the pottery? Once I knew who I was looking for, it was just obvious. Obvious, aye. She says that a lot. What? I think they are waiting your judgment, light who illuminates, etc. Aha, well, let's get on with it then. The shards, I'll find them behind that engraving of me over there, right? Yes, O holiest of holy, just as you... Fine. Then open the passage. Emperor's orders, chop chop. My deepest apologies, you who trample upon the... What is it now? I'm afraid we are one short. Ava, will you do the honors? Where's the other one? Right there. Now, if you'll excuse me for a moment. Uh-oh, are they gonna lock him in there? And nobody touches my suit. Oof. That was a lot to take in. Still puzzled, Acolyte? Some lingering questions? Well, why did you break the plates? How did you know Plint was the Emperor? Did Rendina know who Plint was? I still don't understand. Why did you have to break the other plates? Oh, that was interesting. See, in Munt's chamber, I was struck by the uneven quality of the ceramics. Some refined, some mediocre, others straight out childish. Who would keep such a collection? Only two types of people maintain this kind of decor. Parents with creative children, and self-taught hobbyists. Really? Just because of some bad pottery pieces? If I said this, you'd scold me for fantasizing. Ha, maybe I would. I'll be the first to admit it was a shot in the dark. But it was enough of a hunch to keep me going. See, at points I was tempted to give in and contact the Order. I thought that Mun may have been removed by force. But then when I saw the plate, I was reassured. Reassured of what? Do you know how much skill it takes to split a ceramic plate into five perfectly even pieces? Pieces so even that they balance each other out on a scale? I tried it. I had five attempts and I didn't even get close. That was my little experiment. Ah. Once I knew that a skilled craftsman must have made the votes, and that the Emperor was likely a skilled craftsman, it was enough to convince me that Mun had stepped down voluntarily. I see. Okay, just for fun, I'll ask about Rendina. Lady Rendina? You knew, didn't you, about Master Plint? I never really knew, but I'm not stupid. The Emperor disappears, and about a week later, this odd, skinny, and possibly educated man shows up out of nowhere. Claiming to be, how did he put it? Just one of the fine common folk of this here nation? So that's why you protected him. The man wouldn't have survived a day without me. He had some skill, but he was still very weak. The other farmers would have made short work of him. Thank you, Lady Rendina. Okay, I have no more questions. I have no more questions, Mother. I think I understand it all now. Good to hear. Now listen up. Emperor's decree. In the event that the five leaders of the city fail to fulfill their duties of governance, say, just as an example, by starting to uncontrollably murder each other left and right, the future of the nation shall be decided by vote. On one side of the scales, the God Emperor's return to his position, a nation united under a single divine ruler. On the other side, a council of leaders remains. Their sins are forgiven. Replacements are found for whoever may or may not have recently been murdered. And the rule of five is restored. There shall be three deciding votes. Those will be placed. I, by my holy light, me who illuminate, etc. Two, vigilant mother Superior Tiabata. Three, vigilant sister in training Ava. Effective immediately. End of decree. Questions? Could the votes? No questions. Good. Now I got a little ahead of things and I already placed my vote. Miss Tiabata, ready to do your part? We are vigilant sisters, Your Holy Light. We don't make political decisions. you solve problems. And my problem is, I don't trust these three. But I don't trust myself that much either. The two of you, on the other hand, strike me as the most trustworthy kind. Very well then. The shards are prepared? They are. So, you're Mun. Afraid so, miss. I pray to you, you know. Real sorry about that, miss. It is done. That was fast. So we have to make the deciding vote. I believe it's your turn now, Acolyte. So how do we know which side is which? Your turn, Miss Ava. Okay, let's see. Vote save. But there's no shard left. I believe you have one on you, Acolyte. Oh, right, of course. You want me to use the bloody one? Who knew? Turns out I'm not entirely bereft of the sense for poetic symbols. Boy, this music is really loud in my ear. So which one is yours? The one that balanced the scales. You did this on purpose, didn't you? You wanted it to be up to me. I owe you a choice. A personal one for myself, not for the whole nation. Throw them in the deep end. Emperor rules, leaders rule. Okay. Well, let's go for the leaders and let's see what happens. Play out both endings here. Okay, so we take off. The secret Council of Five is restored, and the nation enters a long period of palace intrigue and backstabbing. The stabbing would sometimes be literal. Oh boy. When the secret of Mun's suit is finally revealed to the public, it comes as a surprise to no one. As it turns out, if five people know, everybody knows. The suit is kept for ceremonial purposes. Most see it as rather silly. Shards of God. Okay, I'm gonna load. That was one great ending. Let me load the other one. Okay, I'm gonna load the vote save, and let's vote for the Emperor. Let's see what happens to the Emperor. Okay, it's even. Okay, we have the pizza. Okay. Emperor rules. Emperor rules. Glory to the Emperor. Emperor Mun remains in power. He's a benevolent god, and for a time the people of the nation enjoy an unusual amount of freedom. Yet the god's attitude soon changes, and he returns to his despotic ways. More such changes would follow, suspiciously coinciding with passing generations. People who point this out tend to mysteriously disappear. Shards of God. Okay, let's... Okay. That was really cool. That was a really neat experience. It was just like for the last 30 minutes, that violin in my ear, it was nonstop. I don't know what it's going to come out like on the video, but it was loud, very loud in my ear. Right away, a volume on this game would be really cool. That being said, I thought it was a really great entry. A really interesting case. Really original, I thought. I'm new to adventure games, but definitely not new to mysteries and, you know, Agatha Christie, stuff like that. And this is definitely like an Agatha Christie meets Dune, you know? Like, it's almost like a... What's her one book? Ten Little Indian? Oh, no. Murder on the Orient Express. I think that's it. Where a whole bunch of them get together to murder the victim. It's not just one of them. So this kind of reminds me of that story. But yeah, no, it was really great. Really great experience. The dialogue was good. I think there's... I don't know how to solve it, but I think some of this was like a little too dialogue heavy. Maybe break it up a little bit more in some places. There was like long stretches of exposition. I don't know what the right term is, but anyway, at any rate, I had a really great time. I hope you did too. If you liked the video, give it a like, subscribe to the channel, leave a comment on what you thought. Maybe you would have tried something different. Maybe when you played it, it was a lot, maybe your experience was a lot different. Maybe put down below what vote you went for at the end. Did you go for both? Like, kind of cheat like I did, or did you just pick one and go with it? But yeah, really interesting story, really great twist near the end, and I liked it a lot. Awesome. Well, have a great day wherever you are, and we'll see you next time, folks. Peace out.